happy Thursday. Can you guys believe it? It's Thursday again. And as promised, we're back with another paint party. Virtual paint party, that is. So, before we start painting, if you guys are not already subscribed to our YouTube channel, here you guys have it. That's Paint the Town Qatar. So if you go on to the YouTube search engine and type Paint the Town Qatar, it will bring you right to our channel. There you guys have it. And if you're not already following us on Instagram, our handle is Paint Qatar. There you go. Take a screenshot. Yes. There you go. And we also now have a website for those who still don't know. There you have it. www.paintqatar.com. There you'll find all of our cool DIY things. So we have paint kits over there, we have clay kits, jewelry, accessory making kits, and I'm glad to announce that now we also have paint by numbers for those who find it difficult to paint freehand. You now have a more guided option, which is paint by numbers. So go on to our website, and there you'll find all the painting options that are available to you. So as promised as well, we also have a live audience tonight. Yay!
five of us.
Anyway, so without further ado, today we will be painting this jellyfish over here. There you go. It looks difficult, but I promise you guys, it's extremely easy if you follow me step by step by step by step. There you go. And we will be using, as announced, our prime paint kit and our pastel paint kits for those who already have those paint kits. But I will be using our very newly launched paint kit, which comes in 7 colors. So for those who have previously ordered the prime kit and the pastel paint kit, you have colors that are very similar to this. So I'll let you know which paint colors I'll be using. There you go. All right. So are we guys ready?
Yes.
Yes. All right. So first we will be starting with the background, which is a blend of black and blue. So first, let me check with my live audience if everyone has their 3 paint brushes.
Yes.
Okay. So we have a big flat brush.
Okay.
A smaller flat brush, a medium brush, that is a flat brush as well.
Yes.
And a circle, a round brush, that is the smallest brush. Yes?
Yes.
Yes, so we're ready to go. Okay, so everyone has the black and blue on their palettes as well. We're gonna start off with the black using the big brush, okay? Here we go, so just dip that big brush in the water that the brush isn't too dry. Okay, and we have some tissue as well. You have the tissue rolls over there. Just dab a bit of the excess water, and then you can go ahead and grab some black. All right. So this painting is actually it's not stressful because it's not about being accurate at all. That might stress because you're a perfectionist, but all right, so let's go ahead and just paint halfway, just like so. Hello. All right,
are we going top again?
Yes, so just halfway, and you can leave that as it is because then we'll paint the blue and kind of blend it with that part. So just, and also don't forget to paint the top part as well as you go along. You don't have to, but this gives the painting a much more finished look in the end.
Thank you.
all the way down, right?
Yeah, all the way down.
If you feel like your brush is a little too dry and it has that kind of effect, just dip the tip of your brush in water and there you go. Feel free to chat amongst yourselves.
Feel free
to chit chat, fine. How's everyone doing with the black so far?
Yeah. So far so good.
Okay. 20 more minutes.
So this is a pre-recorded video, so you can just always go back to
like our training day. Wait, were you on the Google Suite? Like exactly about exactly halfway over. Ish.
Ish, like our like this.
Okay.
Yeah. Also don't forget to paint the bottom part of the canvas. What's that?
You make it look so easy.
But it is though. If you were doing it, you would find it easy too.
Where are you doing
the big brush so that most of the black paint is washed away. Doesn't need to be 100% washed because we need to kind of blend it anyway. So I'm gonna grab some blue now.
Oh geez, here we go.
And don't worry so much about the blend because as you can see the placement of the
it's gonna cover.
Yeah, it's gonna cover well most of it, if not all of it. There you go. Okay, it's got an elbow print. Wow. the background. When we're done with the blue, we'll take a 5-minute break just for the whole background to dry. And then we can start with the jellyfish. We might actually finish quite early compared to the last time. For those who joined us last time, I noticed that you guys liked the dabbing on the tree.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So a lot of it is dabbing right over here.
It'd be better if we had light over here.
The other time was the
same. Kind of houses without lighting. You can't see our mistakes.
How's our blue going, everyone?
Good.
Good? Okay, that's what I want to hear. So for those at home, once we're done with the background, we'll have a 5-minute break, 2 to 3, 5 minutes max break, just for our background to dry. So if you want to go stretch your legs, grab your favorite drink from the kitchen, grab a few snacks from the cupboard, you can do that while we have our break. So your background should look something like this. The light's just reflecting. There you go. Okay.
It's something like that.
All right. Also, don't forget the bottom. I almost did. So I'm painting the bottom as well. There you go. So if your blue seems a little transparent or translucent, wait for it to dry, and then you can go ahead and apply another layer to make it more opaque. There you go. So I'm adding a little bit of water down the middle so that the two colors blend a little better. If you want it to have a better blended effect. Dipping the tip of my big brush in water and then directly applying that in the middle of my canvas. So, there we go. So, by doing that, I've blended the black and the blue a little better. What's that? A little more blue?
Penny.
So for everyone at home, we just finished the background, and we're going to leave our paint to dry, our canvas to dry for about 2 or 3 minutes, 5 minutes maximum. So if you guys want to go and grab yourselves your favorite beverage and some snacks on the side. So the next color that we will be using once we're back to painting our canvas is white. Okay, so let's prepare our white. This time we will be using our medium brush, medium flat brush. There you go. So we will be using the medium flat brush for most of the jellyfish right here. We'll only be using the smallest brush for these parts over here, so you can see, and also the bubbles. So acrylic dries fairly quickly. It just air dries if you leave it, but if you want it to speed up a little bit more, you can do this as well. It does help. For everyone joining us at home, thank you guys for taking some of your Thursday to be with us. We appreciate your online presence, of course. <There you go. laughs> Maybe not towards your face.
I noticed.
If you're joining us for the first time, give us a little hello, a little hi. We'd like to hear from you. And also to those who are joining us again, say hello as well.
Hello.
Hello. If you guys have any questions, our watchers at home, please don't forget to comment, and we'll try to get to your questions as soon as we can. We have a team of Paint the Town crew in the back end of this video who are really quick to respond to any comments. Oh my goodness, do I hear myself? Okay, so this is drying fast. Maybe just a little, just a minute more of doing this and I can start painting the the jellyfish. So the next paint that we will be using is white.
White?
Yes.
Paint? White. White is next.
I wish I could show people online how they're doing this, I swear. So it's just a bunch of ladies doing this in the middle.
wraps up the exercise for the weekend.
Joined us online. Don't fret, you're not late. It's okay. Remember, once we're done with this live, it will be posted on our wall, on our feed. So,
should we get clean water?
Yeah. I mean, okay.
Wait, we're supposed to clean
our
brushes, yeah?
Yes, white. Yes. Thank you. So far we've done just black and blue, half black and half blue, and then blended down the middle, like so. So now we will be using our medium flat brush once your backgrounds are dry. Not yet. Mine still needs a little bit of drying as well. Let me just do this. So what is everyone doing for the weekend?
Oh, the weekend?
Oh, does not exist.
I guess it is our weekend.
Yeah.
My last weekend.
Oh.
I don't know.
Are you guys back to work?
Sunday.
Teachers.
Yeah.
They start school.
Like physically?
Do a boomerang of that.
Okay, I think my background is just about dry.
I feel like mine's dry enough.
Yeah?
But.
Can't get wet.
Yeah, I think
it's
done.
Okay, so while your canvases are still drying, I'll just show you the next step. So it's the medium brush plus the white. Want to make sure that the whole brush is covered in white. So you just wiggle it about to make sure that all the hairs are getting that white paint.
Okay.
Wiggle. Alright. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to outline the shape of that jellyfish. So you just imagine like a mushroom shape, I guess. Yeah. So mine kind of has this, it goes in on both sides, but for this one, I want it to be more round, so I'm just going to do like a mushroom top like that, okay? So I'm going to start right here. Okay. It's okay if you're like,
it's a jelly bean.
It's a very, very okay, fat okay. Jelly bean. So it doesn't matter if your lines are like, you know, kind of, you know, mm-hmm. Gonna make it a little bit messy for those who feel stressed out about it. It's fine. Okay? Doesn't need to be perfect. This painting is not about perfection. So you want it to be like 90% dry when you put the white, otherwise it'll just mix with the blue and the black.
Oh
gosh.
Did you just mix it? There's a little more.
But not too bad.
So still using the white, I'm just going to... So it's like huge gaps, like so.
It's my arms. So
yeah,
what are you on?
Okay. Do you want me to get to show you these? So it's kind of like big dabs like that. using the whole face of the brush. If any of you are struggling, just say, help! No one? Okay. Okay, so now we will be needing yellow. So for our viewers at home, we're done with the white for now. We will be going back to white, but now we need some yellow. My very helpful hand. I know. Okay. If anyone needs an extra palette, just holler at me because I've got them right here. So for this part, you don't necessarily need to wash your brush, so I'm not washing my brush over here. I'm going to grab myself some yellow, and I'm gonna just dab it like so. Okay, so a lot of the painting techniques we're using for this painting is dabbing.
Like Picasso.
He's a dabber.
I was supposed to see that one.
No, you got me a PB.
Yeah, I took it.
Did you roll it?
I did.
I've heard really wonderful things about it.
Yeah.
So for the yellow, I want to go almost like all around, like here. Bottom heavy, but I also want to add some yellow up here.
Okay.
I bet Penny's like, oh, that sounds so easy. I should have been painting.
Easy
one, sweet. But then again, you're a pro, right?
There
we go. Okay, so the next color that we will be painting with is red. Yes, red.
Red.
I'll get rid of that.
So as we're adding the colors, we're closing in the center right here. Purposely blending some of that yellow with the red. Okay, so we're going to mix a green. Can anyone tell me how to mix green? How to make green?
Blue and yellow.
Okay.
Give her a gold star.
All Alright, so grabbing a bit of your blue and a bit of your yellow, we're going to make a green. Okay, so if you want a brighter green, you'll have more yellow than blue. If you want a darker green, you have more blue than yellow. Okay? So I want a brighter green, so I'll have a lot of yellow and a tiny bit of blue. So we're mixing the green color by using the yellow and the blue right over here. So far I'm not washing my brush
at all.
We kind of want the colors to kind of blend with each other.
Green.
Yes. So mix of blue and yellow. And the next color that we'll be putting on top is pink.
What do you do with the center?
So I just put red. Just dab some red there.
Okay.
So we'll be using pink.
Pink?
Yes, pink.
Hello.
Hello.
Pink.
Now we're using
red
pink.
And white.
What's that?
You
just
mix red and white?
No, it's not. We have like a magenta kind of pink,
uh-huh.
Which isn't the same shade that you'll get if you mix our red with the white.
Got it.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So still using the medium flat brush, just gonna grab some pink. And it's really up to you where you want to put that paint, okay? So just dab a few strokes where you please. Okay? So it's up to you where you place the paint. So let's wait for that to dry. The next part that we will be doing is we will outline the jellyfish again with white. Make this part a little clearer again, so we'll add another layer of white over here, and then we'll put some white highlights, as you guys can see, over here on the side, and also some on the top, okay?
How did you do your pink again?
So the pink, I just used the medium flat brush. Grab some pink, and it's up to you where you want to place the pink.
Lines.
Just like, yeah, like long dabs. Yeah.
Oh, the pink's turning all brown.
If it's turning brown, just give it some time to dry, and then you can paint on top.
Okay.
So far your painting should look a little like this. I love the pink because it just pops out like
not mine.
Wait for your painting to dry and then you can add the pink again.
Yep.
Okay. Mm-hmm. These are really nice acrylic paints. They dry extremely fast. I don't know how, are your paints drying fast?
Right.
Relatively fast?
Yeah.
Is mine not?
Okay. I'm
Yeah. Okay. So, once your jellyfish is like 90% dry, we'll just go ahead and outline it again so that the outline is a little more distinct. Using the medium flat brush, I'm just outlining my jellyfish again with white. Outline again up here as well. So now I'm going to add another layer of white down here. We've already done the first layer, so I'm just going to go ahead and dab my second layer of white down here. So on the edges, you want to add like longer white strokes, and as you get to the center, smaller, and then as you go out again, a little bit longer. Can any of our live audience proudly show their painting to me?
Proudly?
Proudly?
Yeah, I can show it to you.
Okay.
But not until it's, mine's kind of brown. I'm gonna wait till it dries a
little.
Okay. What's that? Okay.
I can't really see because, like, the lights is in my...
She's like, you're doing okay.
Are you happy with it so far?
Yeah.
So, no. Okay.
She can't see it with the light in her eyes. She's like, oh, what are you painting, little girl?
I'm a little fish.
I decided to lift two fish instead.
Okay, so while we're waiting for that part to dry, and while our live audience are still trying to finish the head of the jellyfish, I'm just gonna go through the colors that comes with our new paint kit. So they come, the names are actually quite funky. So we have the Panther Pink, we have Casper White, Jerry Brown, Mario Red, Minion Yellow, Ranger Blue, and Darth Black. There you go. And the kit comes like this. I love, love, love the Panther Pink.
I love the names.
It's fun because they're like, where they're good. What? Oh, there you go. It's a jellyfish.
Someone just commented, oh, there you go. It's a jellyfish.
There you go, so far, that's what we have. Okay, so now I'm going to add some highlights using the medium flat brush and white, and I'm just gonna, again, some long strokes like this. So let's do like 1, 2, 3, 4, and on this side as well. 1, 2, 3, 4. And some highlights up here. So it's like 1, 2. Okay. There you go. think we're done with the jellyfish head.
What?
The next part that we will be doing are the colorful tentacles. Is that what they're called? Tentacles? Yeah, tentacles. So we'll be doing the colorful tentacles right over here. There you go. How's everyone's jellyfish coming along?
Yay! How's everybody that's watching
yes.
it live? Do
yes.
they need us
Do
to
you...
slow down? Or is that just like...
Do you want to add the highlight up here as well?
Yes.
So it's a small stroke and then a longer one on the side like that. Okay, so the next color that we will be using is red. So I'm just going to start with the red, still using the medium brush. By the way, for the whole of the jellyfish, we will be using just the medium flat brush. And once we get to these parts here, then we start to use the small round brush. Okay? So for the red, I will just be dabbing over here. Small dabs of red on the bottom part of the jellyfish. So using red and your medium flat brush, I'm just doing small dabs on the bottom part of the jellyfish, like so. Okay, just small dabs of red on the bottom. Have fun with it. Don't stress yourself out. Just, you know.
Did you mix it with white?
No, I didn't mix it with white. It's just the red and the medium flat brush. And just small dabs like that. Now it's really up to you where you want the direction of your tentacles to go. Either you want it to go that way or this way. That's totally up to you. But, you know, choose one side that you want the tentacles to go. So, for the purpose of copying it, copying this painting over here, I'll do my tentacles over here as well. So now I'm going to add my first red tentacle and just dab in like so. Mostly in a straight line, and then going downwards. You guys get the idea? Yeah? See this gap. Okay. To the bottom of your canvas. Okay. There we go. And then I'm going to add another red tentacle right about here. Now I'm just going to do the same thing. Make sure that they kind of go in the same direction. And by the way, they don't have to be the same length, so I'm going to make this one a little bit shorter. There you go. If you feel like your red is a little translucent, once it dries, go over it again with red, and it will be opaque. There you go. Okay.
Somebody remember to change the light themselves next time before we start.
Okay, so the next color that I will be using is a green, so that means I need to mix my blue and my yellow. Okay.
Can you say that part again? Jesse's talking to me.
So I said the next color that I want to use, or we all want to use, is green. So we want to mix yellow with blue. And because I want my green to be more on like the brighter side, I will use more yellow than blue. So it's a brighter green. I'll show you guys what I mean. So it's like that kind of green.
Ooh.
Like a lime green. To add this tentacle next to this red one, but probably shorter. Okay. So if you guys notice, I'm just dabbing. And then I'll cross this over a little bit just to add drama to the painting.
Drama
to the painting. There you go. So I just cross that over the red one, just so that it's not too static. There you go. I'll do the same over here, next to the red one. But on the left side instead of its right.
Has a knee.
What's that?
It has a bend. It's like it has a knee.
It's okay. Okay, so I'm just going over this with a second layer because the first layer is quite translucent. So to make that lemon green pop, I'm just putting another layer. There you go. Yes, now it's popping. To make a light blue color. So it should be more white than blue.
White and blue together?
Yes.
I haven't washed your brush
yet.
I washed your brush.
Yeah.
Just magically. It's called a magic blue.
So this is the blue that you want, the light blue that you want to have right over here. Light blue. Okay. That one. Oh, okay. So I'm going to dab the light blue somewhere in the middle, like that. Dab, 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 and I want it to cross over. Again, it's just dabbing. Dab, dab, dab. I like that. Okay, so after the light blue, we want to use a pink or a light pink. So you can directly use the pink that we used before, or you can mix it with a little bit of white to make a lighter pink. But I like that really bright pink, so I'm just gonna go ahead and use it as is without mixing it with any white. So I'm washing my brush after that light blue. On its own, but you can mix it with white to make a light pink to achieve that kind of color right here. But I like it bright. So I'll use.
Dark dog.
Okay, I'm just putting that on beside the light blue one. My jellyfish looks like so far.
Man, this is good.
Again, if you're not happy with it being translucent, you can always go over it with another layer. What's that?
The other pink? Was it on top of the green?
This pink?
No, the other one.
This one? It's
top
on.
The green.
So this pink is next to the light blue?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so now the next color that we will be using is white. Just to add some highlights on the tentacles that you have existing. Okay. So for the white highlights on the red, I'm just going to add, like, dab a little bit on the side here, and also at the bottom down here. So they're just highlights. They're not tentacles. Someone said that. Also here on the red here, gonna add some white. So, just little dabs. Just little dabs. And I'm gonna add
on top of the red.
Next to it, like on top, next to it, like on the sides. And I'm also going to add some highlights on the pink. So between the blue, the light blue, and the pink, that's where I want to put the white dabs. And I want to do the same between the pink and the blue here on the side. Just dab. There you go. Okay, so I'm done with the tentacles, and this is the next part that we will be doing. I think that's still part of the tentacles, right? Yeah, but like really fine tentacles using our smallest brush. They're so quiet, like, once they turn that off, I'm expecting masterpieces. No, <I'm kidding. laughs> no pressure, guys, no, I'm kidding.
Yeah.
If you need a change of water, now is a good time, while the tentacles are drying. Does anyone need to change their
Oh, sorry, sir.
Oh, never mind.
It's fire.
Okay, so now we will be using our small round brush. So just make sure that all of the hairs of the brush has white, has abs.
No, no, no.
I think I'm on my third.
I'm a
real
So you're on the green.
Well, then she doesn't want pink.
Unless oh, you don't? How could you not want pink?
Okay, it's her not favorite color.
Oh,
so
okay.
Instead, do
yellow. Yes, she can use yellow. So far, this is what our painting looks like.
That's different.
So these finer tentacles are really fun, well, at least for me. I can only speak from my experience. So just using our small round brush and some white paint. This time we want to make sure that the white paint is not thick, so we add a little more water to it than we have been doing. Okay, so we're going to use just the tip of that round brush, and we're going to do fine, like, hairline.
Did you start at the jellyfish
at the
and came
yes.
down?
That's how we're going to do each one of them. So treat it like the jellyfish has hair. You want it to be nice and wavy. So some of them you can leave shorter, some of them longer. Do what feels right to you. Okay, there you go. Starting from the jellyfish, going downwards, and then you kind of like do a wavy line like that. The length of the tiny tentacles are completely up to you. So just enjoy this part, you know?
Oh, I'm loving it.
This one, guys, I'm going.
Okay, you're not there yet.
So if you feel like you've painted enough of those tentacles, you can stop. Because now we will add more of that, but using the yellow paint. Oh! Now I'm using yellow instead of white, and I'm still adding small tentacles.
Did you say put water in the white?
Or yes.
Okay.
Yes. There you go. Now I'm doing the same technique as I did with the white, but using the yellow paint. Okay, still using the small round brush. It's completely up to you how long you want each tentacle to be. And where you want them to be. You can place them anywhere you want. After we're done with the tiny, tiny tentacles, someone tell me what's the next part. The bubbles. The bubbles. There you go. So after the tentacles dry and the whole jellyfish dries, we will be doing the bubbles. And believe it or not, that's the last part. Yeah. Someone online replied when I asked, what's the next part? He was like, bubbles. That's so pretty.
Really?
Yes.
Thank you. Really?
That's so pretty. It is. It's
time,
so pretty.
Last time she said,
wow.
Yeah, she was like, oh, do you like
it? Yes, look at that. It
was
really nice.
It is
really nice. One more time. It's so nice. Can you show us again one more time? Do you want to come over and show them? Yay!
Make them famous. Do not bother me.
While she's painting. Careful with that leg. Yep. Yay! Show them your jellyfish.
That's
just
really
love.
Yes. Thank you so much.
That's
all? Yes.
Yeah.
So for those who have been following us at home, we would love to see your artwork as well. So please send us your final pieces once you're done. And we would love to share it on our social media. Someone just said your painting is cool.
Thank you.
Yay.
I'm cool.
Instagram. You should be like with the
Instagram.
All right. How is everyone else doing? Not there yet.
Not very good. I'm not happy with my tentacles.
No, I know. I feel like I ruined my painting.
Can you show me? Maybe I can suggest. Can you show me? Maybe I can suggest how you can fix it. See. Why are you not happy with your tentacles?
My white ones, they're coming down. I'm still fixing them.
Yeah. I know that's such a pretty jellyfish.
You can't fix perfection, can you?
She said, wait to dry.
turn yellow yet.
So the bubbles are really fun, well, in my opinion.
With a small one?
Yes, with a small brush. So just wash your brush, make sure it's clean because we're using white, so we don't want it to mix with any other color. And also make sure that your jellyfish is
dry.
Fully dry, yes.
Yeah.
This time you want it to be 100% dry.
It's a paper.
No.
Now, are those white dots important?
If you don't want them there, you don't need to have them there. What?
I need more white.
It's okay.
It's fine.
Okay. It's an old one.
Yeah.
It works.
Oh.
Okay, so far the bubbles.
Sure.
So if your jellyfish is still drying and you're dying to do the bubbles, you can start off your bubbles where it doesn't touch the jellyfish. So it's the small round brush. Okay. Alright, so I'm gonna start my first bubble over here. I'm gonna do a big one. Just again, like I said last time, to help support your hand, use your pinky, have it resting on the canvas as a stand or support. There you can feel that your hand is less shaky. That's my first bubble. And the way I did it, if you guys would have noticed, I didn't go all the way around. What I did was I started from top, went halfway, and then started from top again, went the other way. Okay. That way your circle will be more even, and you'll be sure that both ends meet. And then, inside, you just want to do that. First bubble! Okay. So again, it's completely up to you how many bubbles you want. And how big you want them to be, it's up to you. So if you want your bubbles to be thinner, you can use just the tip of your brush. But if you want your bubbles to be thicker, then you just give your brush more pressure. Just press harder and then it will do a thicker line. And bubble. How's yours looking? Okay, so some bubbles you can have overlapping. I'll do one bubble over here, a thinner one and a smaller one, but overlapping the bigger one.
He wants to change. He's not dying, I promise.
You're on the bubbles now?
Well, it makes me a little nervous.
No, help me.
I realized I made my
temple. No, bubbles can go over to this.
So it's completely up to you where you place your bubbles. I'm just showing you how to make them. But you can also copy where I place them, that's fine.
There you go.
I didn't hear any of your tips.
There you go, bubbles are coming along. Okay, since my tentacles are dry, I can go ahead and add a bubble there too. That's the good thing about acrylic paint. Once it dries, you can go ahead and paint over it with anything, and you're sure to not mix, have any blending going on.
So it's like an eraser.
What's that?
So it's like you can erase it.
Almost, yeah. You can. Because once it's dry, it's dry. Like, it won't mix with any other color if you try to put it on top. Because once acrylic dries, it's acrylic, it's plastic.
Oh.
Yep. As many bubbles as you want, anywhere you want, different sizes. I'm gonna add one here right on top of the jellyfish.
On top of it?
Yes.
What? It's something crazy.
Like that.
Aww.
So if you're daring, you can go add a bubble on the jellyfish, but you can stay away from the jellyfish. You don't need to add a bubble on it. You can just have the bubbles around it. That's okay too. I'm so curious to see everyone's jellyfish. For me, I'm just gonna add a couple more bubbles and I should be done. Ta-da!
I'm still drawing my jellyfish outline.
What? Bubbles over here on the black. Do you like it needs a bubble here? Yes. Yeah, it's trying, trying.
He's dry fast.
Ta-da! What's that?
Dry fast.
Yeah. So, I'm done with mine. But there is one thing missing. Can someone tell me?
What's your name?
Signature. Yay! You have done this a lot of times before.
Thumbprint.
Yes. So I'm just gonna put my initials in the right bottom corner using white paint. But it's up to you what color you use. I would suggest you use a bright color, either yellow, a pink, pink or a white because you have a black background here, so you want your initials to stand out. MJD. And of course, the year 2020.
You try not to talk about that year, please.
Okay. Brings bad memories.
What else?
There you go. You guys have it! Our finished jellyfish! Go. And we came to that using just 7 colors. There you go. This is our newest paint kit that comes with 7 colors. And once again, we have the Panther Pink, Casper White, Jerry Brown, Mario Red, Minion Yellow, Ranger Blue, and Darth Black. There you go. All named after characters. And we also launched Paint by Numbers on our website.
Woo!
www.paintqatar.com. So if you want a more guided painting experience in the comfort of your own home without an instructor, then you can purchase yourself a paint by numbers. There you go. Yes, and once again, if you're not already subscribed to our YouTube channel, here it is. Go on to the YouTube search engine and type Paint the Town Qatar and don't stop there. Hit the subscribe button, hit the bell button as well so you are notified whenever we post new content. There you go. And please don't forget to like and share. There you go. And for our Instagram handle, it's Paint Qatar. There you go. Put that in the search engine now. No, I'm kidding. And click the follow button. There you go. And for everyone who joined us live today in person, please don't forget to tag Paint Qatar on your posts.
Hashtag Paint Qatar.
I did.
Hashtag Paint Qatar. It's at Paint Qatar. There you go. And we will share your posts. So, does anyone want to share their final pieces to our home viewers? I know you were dying to show yours. Come.
What can I say?
Yay! And share your Instagram handles too.
My what? Instagram handle and.
There you go! Woo!
Thank you.
Oh, it
Vanessa,
looks so good.
Thank you, Em.
It looks so good.
Love you guys. Follow my Instagram. It's Gadir Bender Official.
Yeah.
So it's Gadir.
Woohoo! Thank you, Gadir. Does anyone else want to show their painting?
I do. I'll
show
it.
Come.
Yeah. Oh, here's another one.
Some bubbles.
Someone said so nice.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, yeah, there you go.
Thank you so much.
Yay! Oh my God. Everyone's like sending hearts, guys. Everyone's like sending us hearts.
Here's one.
Heather's. Yay!
Follow me on Heather Torgerson.
Yes.
Facebook. Oh. I don't know what my Instagram is.
Yay! Anyone else?
I'll show it, but I'm not done.
Oh.
So
but I'll still
nice.
Show her.
Yay! Let's go. Just before we say goodbye, let's share our work.
Oh, that looks cool.
Yay! Oh, that looks so awesome!
Yay!
Ooh, I looked at it.
Right. And anyone else, or shall we close? Thank you, everyone, for joining us online. So Anne's bags just said, clap, clap, bravo. Yay. So thank you guys for taking your time and joining us online. We hope to have you back again next Thursday. Everyone, we hope that you have a great Thursday evening and an even greater weekend ahead of you. Once again, it was your friend Marianne, and this live tutorial was brought to you by us, Paint the Town Qatar, and our lovely partner, Entertainment World Village. Have a great evening. Ciao for now.